My name's Haley Tuck. I'm from Austin, Texas, as you can tell. And this is my life in Paris.
Here's a story about a sinner. He used to be a winner who enjoyed a life of prominence and position. But the pressures at the
My dad was very interested in me getting a job, as most fathers are. So he had my grandmother call the only rare bookstore in town. And so she called and she asked him to hire me. Luke Bilberry, 12th Street Books, go shop there. And he hired me, and I found a book there called Lulu in Hollywood about Louise Brooks. She changed my entire life because she had come from the middle of nowhere, and she left Hollywood, and she ruined her career really leaving Hollywood because she didn't like the way they were treating her. And she went to Germany, and she became a huge star, and I thought that I could do the same.
Thought I would say, damn it all and blow it all. Oh, demon.
We're at Ovio Terry. This is my favorite restaurant, also my second home. During the Tour de France, a pipe broke in my apartment, and all of the hotels were full or unaffordable, and it was late at night, and I couldn't really get a hold of anybody. And so I just came here, where I had sometimes come for wine. They put me up every single time, and they never ask any questions, and they really, really love me here. It's really my second home. I come here most mornings for coffee, and most afternoons for vegetable soup. Every label on the planet had told me, basically, that all my songs were too sad and I had no radio hits. And so I decided to go through the back door. I was looking for the Mark Ronson of jazz. I tried to figure out whose career I wanted, and obviously the career that would be my favorite is Madame Peru. I opened several CDs, literally just opened The Real Deal, and saw multiple times, like Kismet, Larry Klein, Melody Gardot. And I sent an email with my music, and he basically wrote back and said, email me, hit me up if you're ever in LA. And so I basically immediately flew to LA, and I was like, I'm here, I'm hitting you up. And I arrived, and I said, I don't have an album concept yet, but I know that I could if I had a really good producer. And we talked about what I liked about jazz and what I didn't like about jazz. And in classical music, you have, you know, an imperfect cadence or a perfect cadence, but you don't have to know what those are to understand what you're listening to. You can just feel it. I think jazz has gotten a bit too far away from that. I loved the idea of a concept album. I think everybody does. But I talked in particular about an album called We Get Requests by Oscar Peterson with Ray Brown and Ed Thigpen. And it's an album where they took all the songs of the day that they were sick of getting requested. Girl from Ipanema, Have You Met Miss Jones, Corcovado, and they completely redo them in the most amazing way. And I thought that was a genius idea to take something that you thought you were tired of and show you that you're not really tired of it yet.
So bad that a doormat sees better times.
We realized that all the songs kind of had a underlying theme of emotional baggage, of things that you're carrying with you, of addictions, of whatever that may be for you. And I thought it was important. I really wanted to talk about this stuff. I talk about it all the time anyway. My therapist thinks I test people. But I guess I stand by that. I want to talk about it more, and I want people to feel more comfortable with it. And so I wanted to do an album in a way that made them feel more comfortable with it. And we ended up coming up with the concept of junk, which is a song that starts with junk, ends with junk, and is all sorts of junk that you carry with you in between.